next year, I'll be speaking very fast. And in a few minutes, as we're rounding off, if you get anything and you don't get this one, you've not got it all yet because the thing might be away. I'll be speaking on giant fire for giant trumpets. But I will stop at the fire level. I will take other time in church on Sunday to finish the message. Fire. I'll be speaking on the fire aspect. What does fire do? Then I'll have the fire to come upon everyone to put a seal on the prophetic word. I want to appreciate everyone who has ministered here, each person who has testified. Everything they testified about is the grace of God. It's not by my power, by my mind, but because I'm anybody. I'm only with my assignments. Traveling to Burundi, going to plant a church where he is a member and then grew up to the same fire. Going to his campus to preach and began following from there. All those are my destiny. It was not because I'm anybody. I decided to fulfill my destiny and from there began to impact lives. I thank God they also picked up the same spirit to fulfill their destinies. So they came to Nairobi to fulfill their destiny. And there is no destiny fulfilled that does not impact lives. All destinies that are fulfilled must impact lives. Alright. Fire. What does fire do? 12 things that fire do. Number one, fire consumes. Fire does what? It consumes. When you are anointed with fire, there is an atmosphere that will come upon you that will consume and destroy what does not matter in your life. That is why the Bible says, for our God is a consuming fire. For our God is a consuming fire. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 24, our God is a consuming fire. Deuteronomy chapter 9, verse 3, our God is a consuming fire. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29, our is a consuming fire. Number two, fire preserves. Fire preserves. When the grace of God comes upon your life with fire, it will preserve. It will not die anyhow. Now, all these young men have received the fire a long time. And the fire never died up to now. In fact, the fire has grown. In the days when I used to be his pastor, he was not preaching like this. He used to only read Bible for me and run some errands and clean the church fine. But over the years, the fire grew. Fire preserves what you have. When fire comes on you, you are preserved. Over the years, over the months, you are preserved. Number three, fire purifies. Fire purifies. Fire purifies. When something is unclean, when you apply fire to it, it purifies. It will provide. When there are dross or dirt in gold, when you set it on fire, the dross will go. The gold will start shining. So fire purifies. Number four, fire protects. Fire protects. I am just running through the point. I want us to close because I can discover a few people here at the end time. Alright, but we'll close it now. Fire protects. Have you ever seen something that is on fire and you see snake entering there? It's a snake, man. Hallelujah. Or you see something boiling on fire and you see a frog jumping into it. It can never happen. When something is on fire, that thing is protected. Fire protects. Fire protects. Number five, fire empowers. Fire empowers. This TV would not be working like this if not for the fire you plug it into. Electricity is fire. When you are plugged into fire, you are protected. Fire protects. Fire empowers. Number six, fire propels. Fire propels. When you want your car to move, you switch the ignition on
when you switch it on, it brings a different fire that propels the engine and we do so more. Anything you see that is mobile has fire that propels it. Whoever you see manifesting is propelled by fire. Whatever does not have fire inside does not move. The only thing that creates movement, motion on earth is fire. Anything you see on earth moving, check where there's fire inside. Whatever is not moving does not have fire. So fire propels. Fire propels. Everything is moving. Marble. When marble moves, it means fire has been applied to cut it to shape and move it to where it is. Stone, before it moves, fire has been applied to cut it and move to where it is. Anybody you see moving on earth has been propelled by fire. Number 7. Fire pushes. Fire pushes. When fire comes upon you, it will give you a push. Whatever you see me do, it is fire that gives me those push. Get to place and speak a word, it is fire that gives those pushes. You see them start saying, this will happen, and it happens. Fire gives those pushes. Fire pushes you. It gives you a push. If you discover your life is slow, add some more fire, you will start. Fire gives you a push. Alright, the next one. Fire pulls. Fire pulls. No matter how far away something is, when fire comes, it will attract it, it will drag it. Fire has a magnetic force that attracts. It pulls. Have you noticed when somebody is on fire, people will gather to come and watch? What pulls them? Fire. Bible says when Moses was at the burning bush, the bush was burning and refused to be consumed. He was attracted to it. Fire pulls. Fire pulls resources, fire pulls favor, fire pulls honor, fire pulls promotion, and so on and so forth. I just want to give you the point. Time is gone. That's why I'm trying to give you the point. Of course, you know, when I want to tear it, I will bring all the scriptures to show you what I mean, but there's no need for that. Let's go. Number 9. Fire persuades. Fire persuades. When people do not believe you, catch fire, you'll be persuaded. I'm telling you, fire persuades. I told you the story of that pastor that he asked the man to preach his church. My senior pastor was supposed to go, he couldn't go. He asked the man to present him. When I got there, he was angry. He felt so bad. He wondered, right? They sent him a serious. In fact, he went to his boss, brought out 5,000 naira, put in an envelope and arranged it. And told the ushers to take me to the church. So the ushers told me to sit somewhere at the back, hide me and move this last seat at the back. But when fire came down, he couldn't give me that envelope. If I had apologized publicly, he showed me what he could have done. I shouldn't be angry. He wrote a check, he got the secret list. When fire came down, he was persuaded. It's not by size but by stature. When fire comes down, people are persuaded. Hallelujah. Let's go. Number 10. Fire permeates. Fire permeates. When fire comes upon this room, it will enter it. Am I correct? Yes, sir. Excuse me. When you put fire on stone and leave it there for a long time, it will turn the stone to dust. Yes, sir. When you put fire on iron and leave it for some time, the iron will run like water. Fire permeates. It enters deep into places you never think would ever enter. The next one, number 11. Fire provokes. Fire provokes. When fire comes down, things are provoked. If you get to a place and you see snakes lying down, cockroaches relaxing, you know, frogs having a nice time. When fire lands there, you see one of them fighting their spirit. Hallelujah. When you see quiet people and fire comes upon them, they start preaching like thunder. Very humble fellows that doesn't make noise. People like Pastor, the way in the very, the man, He's a phlegmatic. He doesn't mention himself. He likes hiding in one corner, talking very gently. But when fire came, he couldn't hide himself anymore. Fire provokes. When you carry grace inside you and there is no fire in it, you will never do anything. You will die with grace. That is why Dr. Miles Monroe said, the grave is the most prosperous place on earth because many books that were not written are there. Many destinies that refuse to be fulfilled are there. The reason why they are not fulfilled is not because they don't want to be fulfilled. It is because there is no fire to help them to fulfill it. When fire comes, people are provoked to fulfill their destiny. They are provoked. Many people do not like the way their lives are. But the only reason why they are not fulfilling their destiny is because they are not provoked by fire. Only fire can provoke you and sustain the provocation. Over the years, number 12, I'll stop there. Fire brings peace, harmony. Fire settles quarrel. Fire settles quarrel. The reason why there is problem in different churches is because there is no fire. When fire comes down, quarrels are settled. I'm telling you. If you have discovered there is no peace in your life, check if your fire power has gone down. Fire brings peace, uncommon peace. Fire brings so great a peace that you can't believe it. I'll give you a scripture and then I'll add the fire to come. Is that fine? You want a fire? Yes. It will put the seed on all the blessings. You'll be fine. Your family will have peace. Everything will work well when there's fire. Hallelujah. Mark chapter 9, verse 49 to 50. Fire gives peace. Hallelujah. Praise God. I've got made like 21 other points, but I'm not done with this one. This one is introduction. All right, let's close this. I feel the fire everywhere. It will put the seed. Are you there, sir? Wow. I don't want neck. I want Bible. Bible will be okay. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. May God put fire on you. Fire put a seal over your life. Fire makes you an untouchable. Hallelujah. Praise God. Fire makes you an untouchable. It just keeps you. It keeps you vibrant. It makes your life sweet. Hallelujah. See, if you are having a very good complex because you don't have fire, when fire comes, you will never be inferior to anybody. You'll be fine. I started that. Now, each person, if you start the way that I give you ability, if you tell me this one, I will fire you. So, get from the other. It is only lack of fire that brings complex. Hallelujah. Praise God. Fine. Humility is different from complex. I remember there was a day, they asked me to preach in the minister's conference, and I saw elderly pastors who have been preaching before I was born. Fear enters the world with every God. There's no, I am with you. When I stood up and took the microphone and read it, I saw them writing notes. They were checking each other's notes. I said, wonderful. People have been preaching before I was born. Excuse me, sir. Fire gives you confidence. Oh, I can't believe it, you know. That is why you see the logo of one second. It's not a joke. Holy Ghost fireization. I hope it's another point. I'm telling you, when fire comes, you are confident. You are not afraid. I am not afraid of anything. The devil will jump up and come down, break his neck. I am still around. I am not in my job. When I finish, I will walk majestically. He can do nothing to me. Why? Fire gives confidence. Hallelujah. Fire gives confidence. If you want to be confident, it is fire. Number what? 14. Fire makes you competent on earth. If you are looking that you are not competent at something, get fire. Get fireized. Fire makes your soul sharper. Makes your voice hotter. Makes your preaching more fiery. Makes people understand you. I have discovered that if the word God gave me does not have fire, nobody will understand you. He will speak the same. What did he say? He did the Bible. He's lying. He's lying. But when there is fire, they don't even need to quote the Bible. They will believe you. I have not seen anywhere fire now that people don't believe. The Bible says when Elijah commanded the prophets of God, call down fire. They could not from morning till night. And Elijah said, my tongue, Father, prove that we set me up. by that kingdom, everybody stepped on their face, including the morning prophets. Prophets are clear that they bring down fire, they couldn't stand, they were flat at the top. Elijah said, pick them up and keep them. They said, I'm going to die. Because they submitted to death because they couldn't command fire down. When the fire comes down, nobody doubts you. Everybody believes you. Fire conquers fear. God, fire removes something in you. You need fire to manifest. Are you hearing me? You need fire to handle witches, to handle wizards, to handle charms. Hallelujah. You cannot charm me. They can't work. Nobody can. You can't. You can't bewitch me. It can never happen. And from today I prophesy, none of you can be bewitched anymore. You will drink the fire to go. From this day, for the generation of the Jericho, whoever mentions will die by fire. Wait, I will prove it. Didn't you discover that the Bible says it was the people that picked up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego who were slain by the same fire? When you are on fire, nobody gives you up. You are not given. You are unthinkable. Look at the men that beat them up. Who will survive? When you pick up fire, you may never forget this story. Am I saying the truth? I'm running to a kitchen now and carry the burning gas and embrace it. You will smile permanently. That you will smile. You will smile for the rest of it. Hallelujah. Put your hands in a socket with fire. You may never be with it just as a minute and then. Finally, that is where your whole head is. That is who God wants you to be. And I discovered in this life that it takes fire for you to have giant strength. Giant strength is when God enlarges yourself over the head of your enemy. When God gives you an overtaking anointing. When God moves you. When God moves you. In fact, when God causes 10 years to become 10.
Nothing.
the best of the devil is still his worst. I repeat it, the best of the devil is still his worst. It doesn't move me. There can never be a new improved devil anymore. His own is past. It is only God that is new every morning. If you have an account, fire, you have the lasting impact on them. You will be fireproof. You are fireproof. Everything you touch is salted with fire. The Bible says, for everyone shall be salted with fire, and every sacrifice shall be salted with salt. And listen, the Bible uses the word salt here to make you understand what fire does. When fire touches a man, the fire enters by salt and permeates. That's why I got that point. You say, when you do salt like this, in Kenya, they do like this. America, when you are eating, you hear the salt. And in few minutes, it enters into the food, and you enjoy it. That is what happens. Because everyone shall be salted with fire. Fire will act like salt upon you. So every time that this fire comes, may God put fire on you regularly. May God put fire on you regularly. The same way you need salt on every food, that you do it like that. You spray it. There is another one I saw in Nairobi. They do it like this, and they saw, come on. Am I correct? I used to see the benefits. They just turn it like that, and they saw something. May God always do like that for you every morning. Every afternoon. Every night. You are not for the soul. When you eat a sacrifice that has salt, meat that is roasted as it is tasting good. So also when a Christian has fire on him, it tastes good.
Hallelujah.
But when a Christian is fireless, oh my God, it's so soggy, so nasty. And you wonder, when did he even understand you a Christian? Check your life. In the next time you're not prepared, you find you misbehave. You fall into sin. You do not get some things, you excuse. But when fire comes, you taste well. The life of verse 15. Let me go to that. Verse 15. The Bible says in verse 15, salt is good. Now, if you take it back to the first verse of the 19th, it says, everyone shall be salted with fire. What it means is, fire is good. Salt is good for sacrifice. Fire is good for every Christian. And the word that God was speaking, we speak in coded language. Salt is good. Fire is good. He said, but if the salt has not a salt in it, wherewith will it season? Will it season it? Many times salt, fire can lose being fiery. So it begins to go down. It goes down. When you put water, it will take long before it boils. Am I correct? Very long, because the fire is going down. How many of you know when your gas begins to finish, and the way it is burnt, am I right? How many of you say gas, when it's finished, it will be doing like that. It will be going down, then it will remain 2 or 3 minutes burning like that, and you're wondering, after that, you just do, boom, that's all. That's finished. That is how the doctor presents, they are burning like gas, and it's finished. May God reveal you today. I think I'm in the wrong area, my members are empty. I think they've got the spirit of God. You will wake up. Fire makes you sensitive.
Holy Father.
If you don't have another day like this, until May or June, so why don't you do this one? Because this will determine how much God bless you. One thing you do for God that has value to you and God makes up his mind about you. You don't know what he did that would have opened his door and God gave it. You don't know what he did. There were many of them listening to me, shouting when I preach, get very happy when I speak. But I don't know, you don't know what he did. Maybe he just fasted 3 months, one other thing too. And God just said, this one, take this in. And this is working for me. I did not pay his flight. I didn't pay his flight. But that is that case. I only give instructions, and they are here. So understand what I'm talking about. And yes, they have grown to pay flight. You see, praise God. So you can do it, man. Do it, man. Put your mind there. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, we worship you, precious Jesus, my Savior. Holy Spirit, we will honor you. Holy Spirit, we
I'm
was bring to fire and I will close them. I will walk in your midst, fire will cover them. Now that fire can do anything in your life. If you walk with it, you become mighty. If you waste it, it will go. Remember, Father from Uruni told me when you mix him with it, every fire will come there. So do not. Joel chapter 2, verse 3 to 5. He says, a fire devoured before them, and behind them a flame burned. The land is as the garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness. Yea, nothing shall escape them. And verse 4, the Bible says in verse 4, the appearance of them is as the appearance of horses, and as horsemen, so shall they run. Giants tried by fire. The next one, verse 5. So the, like the noise of chariots on the top of the mountain, shall they leave. What does it mean to him? You cross many hurdles at once. That's what it means. Giants tried. You only think giants and when fire is on you. He said, like the noise of a flame of fire that the man of the stubborn as a strong people set in battle array. Fire makes you ever ready. Ever ready, ever ready. Not when they call you, say, don't wait a minute, let me pray first. If I pray for you, not that. Why your prayer gets to work? He was talking about when we speak and it comes to pass. I have told you what it means before that. There are two things. Number one, the office of the prophet and the gift of prophecy. The gift of prophecy is what brings what you hear. God tells you that needs to go to America. In America, you saw Pastor Sammy in America. Praise God. Amen. I mean, it's even so, now, that is the gifts of prophecy. Prophetic gifts. Broken down into word of knowledge, word of wisdom, and gift of prophecy. So the voice comes to you, or in knowing, intuition comes to you, and you know, and then you say that. Are you understanding me? Now, there is office of the prophet. It is the office of the prophet that creates what was not there before. Are you hearing? You don't understand? When you sit in that office, I have not done many times, I will say, this will happen. And I will walk away. I didn't tell you God told you. I use the office that I sit in. And then you see the thing happen. Are you hearing? Yes. The gift of prophecy gives you the word. The office of the prophet gives you the power to create what was not there before. Hallelujah, praise God. That's why the series of now, they are that I declare this over you and it happens. Then when I'm hearing, then I'm hearing a voice speaking to me, telling me this, this, this. Whenever that voice comes, there is details. Have you seen that? Whenever that voice comes at the beginning of the prophecy, I tell you details. This happened, that happened, that happened, that happened. When you are ministering, grace to the prophecy, the gift of prophecy came. That's why you saw his ministry. I was hearing some wonderful part of my calling. Because the continuity, he was ministering service. When I got there, you know, immediately I got him also because the same spirit. And as I hear it, this, I spoke to it at the same time. I don't understand. The gift is there. But the office is when God leads you and gives you that office. Your job is to create it, behave like a God, say it, and it happens. On that something to die, there is not another one to live and abuse. Are you hearing me? Tonight there is a combination of both here. Both the gift and the office. Are you understanding? Both the gift and the office. Hallelujah. Somebody say thank you, Lord. Now, what are the things fire to say? Fire devoured before them and behind them a flame burning. Now watch. What it means is your destiny will be fire projected. Is it? Fire devoured before, and then after them again, a flame is deep on you. It means your impact will last. Yeah. Oh, you didn't hear what I said? It means your prosperity will outgrow you. Yeah. Sleep is serious. It means even after you're gone, your impact will be greater than when you were
gone.
Hallelujah. Praise God. After you have left, you've gone. You are not in Nairobi. People should be shouting about you in Nigeria. After you are not in America, people in Nairobi say, hey, that guy touched me. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. And then the title of the testimony. He was telling you, he said, I pray, I left, and things that happened. That is fire sustained destiny. Fire preserved. You are going to pray now. My destiny. Please be selfish. Pray for yourself. If you pray for yourself and it's worse, you cannot pray for others. Are you hearing? So you can't pray for yourself. My destiny, I prophesy. Are you understanding me? You are the greatest prophet in your own life. I prophesy. You are fire projected and fire preserved. Fire projected and fire preserved. Fire projected and fire preserved. Fire will go ahead of everywhere and fire will preserve me for the rest of my life. On your mark, say, fire now preserve. My destiny, in the name of Jesus, you are fire projected.